Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the City of FAR's 2022 State of the City Address. Please give a round of applause to welcome our Master of Ceremonies for today's event. Joseph Thomas Campos started his acting career right here in South Texas and is a graduate of Mission High School. In the early 2000s, Joseph Thomas landed his first role that would change his life forever, appearing as an extra in the movie The Alamo, playing a soldier in the Mexican Army. His acting career has spanned television series and feature films, including USA TV and the Netflix hit series Queen of the South.
Morning. Give yourselves a round of applause. Y'all look great. Good morning. Wow, good morning, everyone. I want to thank you for joining us today. 2022 City of FAR State of the City Address. You know, it's a true honor to be here today with all of you as Master of Ceremonies. I got a phone call. I'm out here. My name is Joseph Thomas Campos, and I'm proud to be from El Valle. I can't say that loud enough. I'm proud to be from El Valle. Man, feels good to be here. From Mission, Texas, administrators, people like yourselves spoke word into me, and all you need is one voice, somebody patting you on the back saying they believe in you. Boom. I moved to Austin, chased my acting career. I've been fortunate and had the opportunities to be in various television films and TV shows like Queen of the South as your favorite bad boy from the RGV, Boaz Jimenez. You know, it's always nice coming back to the Valley and being a part of such things like this and the opportunities that people like yourself give young ones, you know, so they can follow their dream like this facility. This is something else. This is such a beautiful, beautiful facility. I want to thank Mayor Ambrosio Hernandez and the FAR Commission for inviting me out here to be your Master of Ceremonies. It's a true honor today to welcome the City of FAR 2022 State of the City Address, as Mayor Hernandez is going to be highlighting. What a really great guy too, by the way. Mayor, you're really awesome. He just wants to highlight the many achievements the city's accomplished during the past year, and while sharing his vision for FAR's future. To begin the program, we're honored to have the FAR Police and Fire Department Joint Honor Guard perform the presentation of colors. I ask everyone to please stand. Please stand with me. Now to sing the national anthem. Please help me welcome Mr. Carlos Mena from Vanguard's Academy, Rembrandt Early College High School, secondary.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose by stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gladly streaming. and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Yeah. Wow, talk about talent. Hey, thank you, Carlos. That was amazing. Let's give another round of applause. Leading us in pledge, the Pledge of Allegiance, is Miss Karina Valdez from the PSJA South Swim Team. Miss Karina?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Karina. Outstanding. I'll please remain standing for the invocation. Leading us in the invocation is the Most Reverend Bishop Mario Avias, Auxiliary Bishop of the Catholic Diocese of Brownsville. Bishop?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we approach you today with hearts full of thanksgiving for your boundless goodness and generosity. We pray to you, O God of might, wisdom, and justice, through whom all authority is administered, to assist with your Holy Spirit of counsel and fortitude our Mayor Ambrosio Hernandez, that his administration of our city be conducted in virtue and be useful for your people over whom he presides. Let also Almighty God, the light of your divine wisdom, direct the deliberation of the City Council, so that seeking always peace and the happiness of the citizens of this city, they may increase industry, sobriety, and knowledge, so that all can rejoice in true freedom. We commend also to your boundless mercy all the citizens of the city of Far. Bless them, sanctify them, grant them health of mind and body, and preserve them in the peace of which this world cannot give. O Lord of mercy, we commend to you also the souls of those citizens of this great city who have departed from this life, the souls of parents, grandparents, relatives, and friends, particularly those who have died during this pandemic. Grant them all that rest in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and everlasting peace. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Bishop, again for the wonderful invocation. You may all be seated. You may all be seated. Please take a seat. Now, before we officially begin our program today, I'd like to acknowledge the City of Far special guests who've taken the time out of their busy, busy schedule to join us for this very special event. Got all the names here, y'all. Fortunate enough to have these great elected officials. And now let's just welcome our elected officials along with our federal and state governmental agencies and offices who are present from FAR. Mayor Dr. Ambrosio Hernandez, Commissioner Dr. Ramiro Caballero, Commissioner Ricardo Medina, Commissioner, please hold your applause till the end. Don't make me bust out the little guy. I'm gonna take him out anyway. Seriously, just hold your applause. Commissioner Bobby Carrillo. Commissioner Dr. I said hold your applause, please. Commissioner Daniel Chavez. Commissioner Elizar Guajardo. Commissioner Itza Flores. FAR International Bridge Board. Tony Martinez. Luis Flores. Larry Hernandez from the Federal. Office of United States Senator John Cornyn. Office of United States Senator Ted Cruz. Office of Congressman Vicente Gonzalez. Brian Hastings, Chief Patrol Agent for Border Patrol. Randy Howe, Director of Field Operations, Laredo for Customs and Border Patrol. Border Protection, sorry. State Senator Juan Chuy Hinojosa. State Representative Sergio Munoz. Chairman Terry Canales. Office of State Representative Oscar Longoria. Office of State Representative Bobby Guerra. Julian Alvarez, Commissioner on Labor, Texas Workforce Commission. Judges, Judge Luis Singletary, Lewis Singletary, 92nd District Court. Associate Judge Criselda Hinojosa, Title 4D, Master Court 1, Hidalgo County. County Commissioner for Precinct 2, Eric Cantu. County Commissioner for Precinct 4, Eli Torres. District Attorney, Ricardo Rodriguez. District Clerk, Laura Hinojosa. Tax Assessor, Paul Villarreal. Mayors, Mayor Chris Boswell from the City of Harlingen. Mayor Mario Garza, City of San Juan. Mayor Ramiro Garza, City of Edinburgh. Mayor Armando Ocaña, City of Mission. What's up, Ocaña? Mayor Javier Villalobos, City of McAllen. Mayor Carlos Peña Ortiz, City of Reynosa, Mexico. City Commissioners, Commissioner Joaquin Zamora, City of McAllen. Commissioner Tony Aguirre, City of McAllen. Commissioner Omar Quintanilla, City of McAllen. Commissioner C.B. Harad, City of McAllen. Commissioner Pepe Cabeza de Vaca, City of McAllen. Commissioner Johnny Garcia, City of Edinburgh. Commissioner Ruben Plata, City of Mission. Commissioner Oki Salinas, City of Alamo. Commissioner Lenny Sanchez, City of San Juan. And any school board members, please stand and be recognized. And if there are any elected officials who are not called, please stand and be recognized now. Give these guys a big old round of applause. Now you can applaud. I want to thank you all again, the City of FAR, special guests, elected officials, for bringing us here today. Now as you sit there today in this beautiful, beautiful Olympic-sized facility, I ask that you turn your attention to the screens. Thank you.
And now, let us welcome to the stage a true champion who started her athletic career in a pool just like this one. Please give a warm welcome to Miss Brenda Villa. Hailing from Commerce, California, Brenda Villa is one of the greatest women's water polo players of all time. Brenda led Team USA to medals in four different Olympic Games, culminating with gold at the 2012 Olympic Games in London. Since her retirement from international water polo following the 2012 Olympic Games, Villa has pursued another passion, giving back as co-founder of the Brenda Villa Foundation, a nonprofit organization committed to providing aquatic opportunities for under-resourced communities.
Thank you and good afternoon, City of FAR. I wanted to congratulate all of you for this amazing facility and thank Mayor Hernandez for inviting me out. I was lucky enough to be out here 3 years ago where I conducted a few clinics and I saw myself in a lot of the younger athletes that I was training for those 2 days. And really dreaming big. And it all starts with access to resources, access to a community pool like this pool. I grew up in a small city that had an amazing facility, and that allowed me to get into aquatics, to be water safe, and to learn so many more opportunities in the aquatic world. And I know that this facility can do that for the youth of the Valley. And I'm so inspired to continue to watch from California to see the growth of athletes in aquatics. And I hope to be back when you all host maybe an NCAA championship, a FINA event, or who knows, even an Olympic qualifier. So I know some of the athletes are here, you know, for you, don't be afraid to dream big. I was able to dream big because I had a great facility to give me that foundation. And to all the adults in the community in the room, be the support system that they need in order to help them dream big, because when your community supports you, I know you can be successful. I know that from my own experience of becoming a four-time Olympic medalist and Olympic champion. So dream big and congratulations on such a beautiful venue you all have here. Thank you.
Just as water is life and should never be wasted, the City of FAR wasted no time in advancing the needs of its community in 2021. 2021 was a year filled with economic growth, quality of life increases, brand new opportunities for all its citizens, and challenges of dealing with a global pandemic. The City of FAR moved quickly and decisively to address the healthcare emergency that COVID posed to the community. The City of FAR was the first city in Hidalgo County approved by the state of Texas to be a COVID-19 vaccine provider. To address the needs of our seniors, Operation Senior Care was launched in order to provide the vaccine to seniors in their homes. FAR also partnered with the Hidalgo County Precinct No. 2 to vaccinate people in adult daycare centers. Over 850 vaccines were administered. The largest COVID-19 vaccination clinic specifically for farm workers in the Rio Grande Valley was set up by the combined efforts of the City of FAR, U.S. Department of Labor, Texas State Senator Eddie Lucio, and numerous organizations and nonprofits. This effort resulted in over 1,000 local farm workers getting vaccinated. The expansion of the I-2 and I-69 interchange has been a project that has been needed and planned for years. 2021 was the year that all the planning became a reality. The City of FAR, the Texas Department of Transportation, and Dragados Police Construction held a groundbreaking ceremony in September, celebrating the construction of the I-2-I-69 interchange project. This $303 million project will be 8 miles long and consists of 4 lanes in each direction. It is planned to be completed in the fall of 2023 and will bring great improvements to area mobility. a crucial summit to discuss the Border Transportation Master Plan, BTMP, was held in Farr. The City of Farr welcomed Texas Secretary of State Ruth R. Hughes and members of the Rio Grande Valley Metropolitan Planning Organization's Transportation Policy Board to the Farr Event Center for a discussion on the Border Transportation Master Plan. Farr continues to be the hub city at the crossroads of the area, continually improving transportation infrastructure. The Farr-Reynosa Bridge annually is responsible for over $36 billion in trade and about 650 million commercial vehicle crossings. The Farr Second Bridge Expansion Project will make it the safest and most efficient border crossing in Texas. The City of Farr hosted U.S. Senators John Cornyn and Ted Cruz, as well as 19 key United States senators across the country at the International Bridge. This visit marks the first time in Farr's history that so many federal legislators visited Farr at the same time. The senators were given an overview of increased international trade and commerce, which was spearheaded by U.S. Customs and Border Protection in Farr. Area representatives wanted to emphasize to our U.S. senators the importance of international border trade, along with the southern border, our thriving economy, and how international trade drives the Farr, state, and national economies. In October, the Farr International Bridge hosted its annual special event to celebrate the state of the 2021-2022 produce season. The U.S. has consistently remained Mexico's number one trading partner for produce and other goods, and Farr's ideal geographical location has not only created a great partnership between the two countries, but has also greatly increased their trading capacity. With 65% of all crossings, the Farr-Reynosa International Bridge has evolved into the largest land port for fruit and vegetables in the nation. The City of Farr and the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley held a signing ceremony in September to celebrate the UTRGV School of Nursing facility expansion. It will increase access to healthcare in Farr and help with the nursing shortage in the region and increased preparation for COVID-19 response. This was made possible part of the U.S. Commerce $2 million grant from the CARES Act funding program. The Farr Economic Development Corporation launched a new EDC foundation focused on education for students, post-secondary education, entrepreneurship, and business development. The EDC Foundation also created a scholarship program for Farr students, awarding 120 scholarships, each at $2,000 per year, for qualified applicants enrolling in post-secondary education. This program is truly helping our students achieve their goals. Reimagining what a city hall designed the needs of its citizens could be. That was the goal of Farr City Hall remodeling. 2021 saw a grand opening for the City Hall's first floor, where the newly remodeled space will provide Farr citizens with more accessibility, as well as enhanced areas designed to an open and welcoming environment. The first floor includes development services, meeting rooms, engineering department, and the Park Bench Deli. Housed in the renovated City Hall is the new mayor's mural, which recognizes all the Farr's former mayors for their contribution to the city, commemorating the 25 mayors who have governed the city over the last 100 years. 2021 also saw the completion of City Hall Park. This area surrounding City Hall is a modern urban public space that is currently being used for festivals, farmers markets, and food trucks. City Hall Park represents another example of Farr's forward-thinking urban planning initiatives. The City of Farr Police Department and Hidalgo County District Attorney's Office launched a domestic violence crisis response unit. They partnered with community agencies and organizations such as DHR Health Safe Haven, Forensic Exam Center, Hidalgo County Community Service Agency, and Women Together, Mujeres Unidas, to support the unit's cause. In June, the City of Farr Public Works Department responded to numerous calls in South Farr to deal with heavy flooding, asking residents to remain in their homes as crews remove excess water of streets and neighborhoods. Farr remains committed to focusing on drainage improvements to help protect homes and businesses from future flooding. the City of Far and the Office of Grants Management and Community Development were awarded additional CARES Act funding for their Emergency Utility Assistance Program, with up to $500 in eligible assistance is available. The City of Far hosted its biggest event of the year, the Far Hub Festival themed Country Boots Tejano Roots, paying homage to the city's roots. At the heart of the Hub Festival was live entertainment, including Bo Garza, Steve Valdez, Bobby Pulido, and the band Perry. City of Far held a time capsule ceremony to honor the city's past, present, and future rich history with relics that will be viewed by future Far leaders and citizens in the year 2070. The Hidalgo County Bar Association awarded Mayor Ambrosio Hernandez the Hidalgo County COVID Heroes Award. This award recognizes any first responders or frontline workers that have put the care and safety of their community first while putting their life at risk in response to the pandemic. Also, at this year's Texas Transportation eForum, the Texas Department of Transportation and the Texas Good Roads Transportation Association awarded Far Mayor and RGV MPO Chair Dr. Ambrosio Hernandez the 2020 Road Hand Award. The award recognizes those special individuals who have freely given their time, energy, support, and vision towards accomplishing crucial transportation programs or projects in their community, region, and even the entire state. Far Mayor and RGV MPO Chair Dr. Ambrosio Hernandez received the VITA Award. VITA helps low-income, unemployed, and underemployed residents in the Rio Grande Valley get the education and training they need to secure high-skilled, high-wage jobs. Hernandez was also thanked for his visionary leadership in recent achievements such as the citywide broadband internet service project and the expansion of workforce training programs in collaboration with South Texas College to address the expansion of UTRGV's School of Nursing and that industry's demand. An ocean of opportunities of what FAR's future looks like. FAR is poised to enter 2022 with confidence, strength, and optimism.
Let it go. This is not my beautiful house. And you may tell yourself, this is not my beautiful wife.
Letting the days go by. Let the water roll me down. Letting the days go by. Water flowing under back into the blue again. After the money's gone. Once in a lifetime. Water flowing under ground.
Water dissolving and water removing. There is water at the bottom of the ocean. Under the water.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Honorable Mayor, Ambrosio Hernandez, M.D.
Great diving skills. Great swimming skills. Good job, guys. I'm going to get my notes out. I know Dr. Singh's here, and before he reminds me, I've actually done all my medical records, so don't bring that up. We're good to go. Good afternoon. And welcome to the City of FAR's 2022 State of the City Address. It's such an honor to be delivering this address once again in person. Even as we remain in this midst of a global pandemic, now entering its third year, we are hopeful and appreciative of the scientific breakthroughs, the education and tools that we know work to help prevent the spread and treat the disease, and the resources that are helping us manage the best we can. I want to thank you for being here with us today in this breathtaking new facility, which was just completed construction. Just take a quick moment to look around at its grandeur. This is an awesome facility. We want to thank you to our sponsors for making this event possible. As always, this event is put on with 100% sponsored funds, and any proceeds are made towards donations to local organizations that are serving our community. We chose this unique venue to host this event because we wanted to highlight the endless opportunities that are possible when we dream big, we come together, and we make things happen. This facility is a partnership between the City of FAR, PSJISD, and UTRGV. This facility will expand opportunity for students and community members to have access to a state-of-the-art Olympic-level competitive training facility in the healthy but low-impact sport of swimming. I want to recognize representatives from PSJISD, Dr. Jorge Arredondo, and his board members, I think Dr. Cinta Gutierrez and Jesse Vela. Could you please stand? And of course, our other partner, UTRGV, who has just joined us here today, can you please stand and be recognized? Now, when I was growing up, my generation rarely had opportunities to participate in these leisurely activity of swimming. I don't know about you, but most of the time, it was really reserved for people who were rich, so that did not apply to me. We did not have widely available access to swimming pools either at home or in the community. So many of us, we learned how to swim or even considered it as a sport. I mean, we didn't even consider it a sport at all. Special occasions such as staying at a hotel or going to the beach, it provided the rare opportunity to try our best, for instance, dog paddling or even treading water, right? Not exactly an Olympic sanctioned sports. But that changes today. As leaders now in our communities, we have the opportunity to dream big and do big for our residents and for our future generations. This is definitely a life-changing moment. We have a calling to leave behind a legacy of hope, of infinite possibilities, and of letting them know that they are worthy and deserving of the best that we can give them. And that is why this year's State of the City theme pays tribute to that. Because here in FAR, together we can win. Now, just as we are transforming the landscape of our great city of FAR, with major construction and infrastructure upgrades that can clearly be seen by everybody. We are transforming the mindset of our FAR residents and future generations. And we're planting the seed that indeed anything is possible. For instance, like hosting in high school and collegiate level swimming competitions against the competitors on a national and state platform. We're going to prepare our students to compete at the next U.S. Olympic trials, acquire the necessary life-saving techniques to prevent our young kids from drowning, or, like, you know, learning how to swim at a ripe age of 70 years of old, training hard and competing in your own swimming competition. Where's Jim Darling? Jim, you got a chance now. Get in it. Anything is possible. Dream big. Imagine the possibilities. That's what we do in FAR. So as the mayor of this great city, I'm here to announce that in 2022, the state of the city of FAR is prospering, highly innovative, exceeding expectations, and continuing to strive towards excellence. Now, 2021 can continue to be a year filled with both challenges and opportunities for us to meet, address, and resolve head-on. And that's what the city of FAR did. You saw our efforts in the highlighted video, but it's important to remember that as this pandemic evolves, FAR will continue to remain vigilant and ready to proactively strategize and respond to any situation as it develops. For example, in 2021, we responded swiftly and decisively with the utilization of our federal funds made available for the COVID crisis, including collaborating with DHR Health and Hidalgo County Precinct 2 for vaccine clinics. We were first in the state to implement homebound visits and vaccinate our elderly and high-risk population who could not make it to the vaccine clinics, along with the largest effort to vaccinate farm workers in the valley. We provided FAR families with financial resources for their daily needs, and we invested in broadband infrastructure, but I'll touch that in a little bit later. We kept the city operating, fully functioning at full capacity. Our businesses remained open, and we continued supporting the efforts to keep our schools and families safe. Now, FAR continues to lead in providing innovative responses to the ongoing and ever-changing COVID crisis with partners such as DHR Health and Hidalgo County Precinct 2. Now, you can rest assured that this administration will always, always keep the health, safety, and well-being of our residents and families our top priority. Now, let's recognize both DHR Health, here with us today is Dr. Manish Singh, our CEO, Marisa Padilla, and of course, also with us is Commissioner Eric Cantu, or as I call him, Big Dog Cantu. He's here with us today. Thank you, Commissioner. Thank you both for your efforts. One of the major moves that FAR made in 2021, unlike any other, was to acquire assets and take over emergency medical services from a company that went bankrupt. Now, we saw an urgent need to increase the quality of emergency medical services that would impact the health, safety, and lives of hundreds of thousands of residents across the city and county. Now, why on earth would the city do this proactive measure? Why? Well, in a medical emergency, don't you want your loved ones to have access to safe, rapid, and emergency ambulance services? And it's more than that. We need to have the right people show up at the right place, with the right certifications, the right equipment, the right ambulance, not wait for a second ambulance to show up and finally take us to our destination. Because we all deserve better. Time is everything in an emergency, and we could not let our community down. Here in FAR, we will do everything in our power to ensure that our families and our neighboring communities have access to the best emergency medical services available, period. Now, in April of 2021, we received approval from the United States bankruptcy judge to purchase all assets of the former EMS company, all debt wiped out, clean slate. And we established the first ever City of FAR Emergency Medical Service Department, FAR EMS. Now, we transformed the former FAR Event Center into a state-of-the-art emergency medical facility. In just 2 months, we were operational, completely operational, an unheard-of accomplishment. We currently have 112 employees in the department, with a current fleet of 11 frontline ambulances with 20 in reserve, 10 command staff vehicles, a helicopter, and an airplane. That's what we call a great start. Our 911 service area covers approximately 460 square miles and includes the city of Far, Hidalgo County Emergency Service District 2, which is comprised of the cities of Monte Alto, La Villa, El Cauchelsa, and surrounding rural areas. Also, Hidalgo County Precinct 3, which includes the cities of Alton, Palmhurst, Peñitas, Sullivan City, and McCook. Without Far's swift response to address the EMS service gap that the former EMS company serviced, there is no telling what state of emergency these surrounding communities may have found themselves in. So I am proud of the leadership of our city commission, administration, and employees for the rapid response to this dire situation and responding accordingly to the needs of our surrounding community. And this year, 2022, I am excited to announce we're going to make even more ambitious moves with a new vision and approach to emergency services. A merger of resources to create one united department and facility that includes EMS, police, and fire personnel, all certified in EMS capability. The first of its kind in the RGV, a new fire EMS superstation. Now, this brand new state-of-the-art superstation will be a two-story, 35,000 square foot facility, which will include fire and EMS administration, conference and training rooms, dorms for staff, warehouse space, and of course a hangar and helicopter landing pad for RGV Angel Flight. This new facility will allow FAR to effectively respond to emergencies region-wide. Because in FAR, that's what we do. We innovate, we strive for excellence. Speaking of excellence, I mentioned to you guys last year, every decision we make in FAR is weighted against the following criteria. First, strategy, how we establish and plan to implement strategic directions. Second, our constituents, how can the decision we make best benefit our constituents? Third, operations, how can we design, manage, and improve processes? And fourth, results, how we perform in terms of our constituent satisfaction, finances, operations, governance, and social responsibility. As we have mentioned in previous State of the City addresses, FAR took on the initiative strategically to improve operations, aligned with the evidence-based practice of major companies, corporations, and government entities that subscribe to the philosophy of excellence. This past year, FAR moved closer, much closer, to achieving the highly coveted Malcolm Baldrige National Quality Award, the nation's highest presidential honor for performance of excellence, and to one to which FAR strives to achieve. At the City of FAR, we continue to emphasize the importance of performance excellence. In April, we were awarded progress level recognition from the Quality Texas Foundation. So we are currently two steps away from reaching our goal of national recognition. This is a journey that many organizations attempt, but very few achieve. But we are going to get it done. We continue to strive to be a city that provides service excellence and a culture of continuous improvement. Here in FAR, we know nothing is impossible, and we will continue to adapt to address and attain the necessary tools and processes to achieve and be recognized for performance excellence in our city government operations. All for you, the residents of FAR. Now, FAR remain among the top three compared to neighboring cities in growth. Our property taxes increased by nearly 7% this fiscal year alone. Our general fund increased by 22% due to the city growing in personnel, civil service new collective bargaining, and major investments in street repairs. Meanwhile, our city budget increased by 44% because of our capital improvement projects The new TeamFAR.net, TeamFAR.net is a citywide broadband service, and the new EMS department. Now, complementing these investments is a healthy fund balance and a company credit rating, both representing a healthy and strong fund balance that supports our growth. So to be clear, none of these investments mentioned will require an increase in tax rate in the city of FAR. Great accounting. In FAR, we are responsibly investing in our community and laying the foundation for the success of our future generations. As I just mentioned, the administration will always, always keep the health and safety and well-being of our residents and families as our top priority. And we're not afraid to think outside the box. This past year, we made a history at our FAR Police Department with the first ever nationally certified horse patrol officers in the Rio Grande Valley. It was another moment that we seized opportunity to acquire land in FAR for the training facility in an effort to introduce new, safer, innovative, but most importantly, community-friendly policing initiatives. We partnered with the National Horse Patrol Certification Program through the Rio Grande Valley Border Patrol sector. This was a history-making moment and the first Horse Patrol Police Department unit in the region that allows direct contact with law enforcement agencies, such as the FAR Police Department and Border Patrol, in a friendly, social environment. After all, who doesn't like petting or riding horses, guys, right? Kids love it. It also introduces our children to a potential, right, career at a young age and reduces anxiety associated with law enforcement. That's what I refer to as a win-win scenario. So congratulations to the FAR Police Department and the RGV Border Patrol. Chief Hastings is with us today, and his teammates, thank you. Thank you for your participation and your assistance in this endeavor, and the Border Patrol, thank you. Now further, affirming our commitment to public safety, in July, FAR made significant progress to a long-standing negotiation process that spanned almost 2 years, and we approved three-year contracts with both fire and police unions. The collaborative effort will help to efficiently manage all our responding units and stations during emergency situations. These new agreements demonstrate how much the City of FAR values its employees, and we are grateful for such excellent staff that continue to serve our citizens. Now, continuing the theme of keeping the health, safety, and well-being of our RGV families as a top priority here in FAR, 2021 brought us major advancements. As a physician and your mayor, the City Commission and I see firsthand the importance of access to healthcare funding for the region. We all have personal stories of loved ones that have been struck with cancer and were limited to life-saving cancer treatments. This is unacceptable. Historically, the state legislature has funded Cancer Prevention Research Institute, better known as CPRIT, that oversees a $3 billion budget. That's a $3 billion budget, ladies and gentlemen. CPRIT awards highly competitive funding mechanisms in areas of cancer prevention, academic research, and product development in its fight against cancer statewide. However, prior to 2020, the Rio Grande Valley had no voice on CPRIT funding. Zero. Our higher ed institutions, hospitals, health systems, and patients were continuously left out of millions of potential life-threatening funding mechanisms. As such, a CPRIT appointment was desperately needed for our region. And you guys know the old saying, el que no habla, Dios no lo oye. Well, we did ask, and I'm happy to report and proud that I was appointed to the CPRIT board. Now, this did not happen by mere accident or chance. The appointment was a direct result from a local health system governing board request, DHR Health, and our two senators, Chuy Hinojosa and Eddie Lucio. Thank you, DHR Health, senators, and Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick, for believing in me, the City of FAR, and the RGV. We asked and we received, and we are proud to announce. In August, we were pleased to announce that a $2.5 million cancer research grant was awarded to UTRGV by CPRIT. the first of its kind. This was very exciting news for the Rio Grande Valley and Texas, and it further solidifies UTRV's Fairly Young Medical School's significant but emerging role as a leader in cancer research. Funding will provide researchers with countless opportunities for innovative and creativity to examine cutting-edge and breakthrough treatments for cancer for our patients right here in our backyard. So, congratulations, Dr. Bailey, Dean Hawker, and to the UTRV research team. Please stand to be recognized. Now remember, this is only the beginning. Partnerships matter. We matter. We are bringing exceptional and comprehensive cancer care to you at home now. Continuing the discussion on healthcare needs and collaboration, the FAR City Commission recognizes that the pandemic has exposed critical weaknesses in our healthcare system, specifically in the nursing profession. Now remember, we already had a national shortage in nurses, even before the pandemic. This mainly stemmed from not a lack of students. As a matter of fact, 700 students were turned away in the Rio Grande Valley for nursing positions. This was mainly due to lack of slots, educational slots. Some of our nurses, unfortunately, even fell ill. Some passed away during the providing care to our loved ones. Some, unfortunately, were recruited to other areas of the nation, leaving our local healthcare systems severely understaffed to the detriment of our families. Well, as such, we have taken a proactive role for our region for the benefit not only for our FAR residents, but for the entire RGV. So in September, the City of FAR and UTRGV announced a historic partnership, the signing ceremony for UTRGV's new School of Nursing facility in FAR. The new facility will be constructed in FAR as part of a U.S. Department of Commerce $2 million grant from CARES funding. The project goal is to address nursing shortages in the RGV to resupply and provide continuous supply of nursing graduates. We are extremely proud to partner with UTRGV to educate and train the future nursing workforce in our region using our RGV students. With us today is Dr. Mary Jane Lewitt, Dean of the School of Nursing. Please stand to be recognized. Thank you for your efforts and your partnership. As a physician myself, I understand the need we have for nurses, but as a mayor, I am proud that this facility will be located here in FAR, where access to UTRGV and all our regional hospitals are closely situated. As a matter of fact, it's going to be right across the street where the FAR Event Center is. Like I mentioned last year, we received a presidential permit approval from the White House and the U.S. Department of State in record time. Record time? Under 90 days, to be exact. That is impressive. But wait, the City of FAR did not stop there. This past legislative session, FAR played an active and strategic role in implementing and passing legislation to improve and expand programs and initiatives at the FAR International Bridge to benefit international trade and commerce, and ultimately benefit FAR's position as a global trade leader. As an economic engine of the region, FAR's emphasis on specific legislation not only helps FAR, but actually helps all 28 ports of entry in the RGV. Now, some of our successes this legislative session included House Bill 2843 and its companion bill, Senate Bill 1334. This was filed by Senator Juancho Hinojosa and sponsored by Representative Terry Canales, Chairman of the House and Transportation Committee. Prior to our efforts under Texas laws, cities, counties were not, and I repeat, you were not permitted to issue bonds to invest in facilities, technology, or other infrastructures to donate to the federal government for ports of improvement. This bill provides the cities and county old toll bridges another funding tool to invest in all ports of entry for infrastructure, allowing all communities like the City of FAR, City of McAllen, City of Donna, to leverage our own local dollars to strengthen our economy and bolster the safety of our ports of entry. Second legislation FAR was intimately involved with was House Bill 1371 and its companion, Senate Bill 1566. This was originally co-sponsored by Senator Lucio and Representative Guerra in their respective chambers. Now, this bill provides continued congestion relief at the ports along the South Texas-Mexican border by extending the Trade Agriculture Inspection Grant Program, better known as the South Texas Asset Consortium Program, or STAC. The continued implementation of the program will allow our Texas ports of entry to build the personnel and the efficiencies needed to protect our Texas farmers, encourage the growth of the Texas fruit and vegetable industry, and help our Texas economy grow by creating a partnership where local communities, alongside with the state government, can fund necessary personnel and needed to move the proper flow of trade on all bridges. A third key piece of legislation FAR was involved with, Senate Bill 2243, or as we call it, the Hail Mary Bill. This was championed by Senators Juan Chu Hinojosa, Chairman Canales, and Senator Lucio. The legislation amends the Transportation Code by providing an exemption from the Texas Transportation Commission approval for the reconstruction or improvement of existing bridges over the Rio Grande, including the FAR International Bridge. The reason it's called Hail Mary Bill, because we filed it after the filing date deadline. But we filed it as an emergency bill in the Texas Senate, and it made its passage in record time of 21 days. Ladies and gentlemen, that's what we call influence. Very good influence. Now, by allowing an exemption for existing bridges, we have the permits and we've already undergone the process. This will expedite the rate at which we can work on improvements, reconstruction, or even construction at our current bridge. Now, since the City of FAR received a provisional permit for the expansion of the bridge in late 2020, this bill expedites the lengthy process to move construction of the expansion along expeditiously. As a matter of fact, it will open in the fall of 2023. The City of FAR is thankful for the support and dedication of our elected officials who led the City Commission's effort to pass this important legislation. The City of FAR's legislative successes could not have been possible without the hard work of our City Government Relations team and the support of our state legislature. Thank you to our South Texas delegation for always supporting our efforts to enhance efficient trade and commerce and contribute to our local, state, national, and quite frankly, global economies. As stated earlier, our City Commission is proud to move forward the City of FAR and all 28 ports of entry along the Texas southern border. Remember, what is best for FAR is great for the state of Texas. What moves FAR forward moves all present and future bridges and ports of entry forward. Now let's take a moment to recognize and thank our RGV state legislators. Please stand and be recognized. Now, what better way to culminate successful legislation than to see it firsthand? Well, there's no better example of this than our annual Start of the Produce Season event. As is customary, we celebrate Start of the Produce Season by welcoming guests to a show-stopping array of brightly displayed fresh fruits and vegetables held at the FAR International Bridge. Guests include dignitaries and produce growers, importers, distributors, and consumers from the United States and Mexico. All these legislations that were passed, all these efforts by our state delegation are making these things come to reality. Now, this is a great event demonstrating the importance and impact of international commerce, but also the robust binational cooperation and family unity. It is truly beautiful to see the regional and international collaboration between our border communities. Now, as you can see, or you can tell by the construction of the interchange, and don't worry, It's supposed to be done in 5 years. It's being done in 3 years. 3 years, 2023. And many other road projects. FAR and its partners continue to move swiftly to enhance transportation for our booming South Texas population. In April, the city of FAR hosted Texas Secretary of State and the RGBMPO to discuss the Border Transportation Master Plan, better known as BTMP, which addresses the needs, challenges, opportunities, and funding strategies such as public-private partnerships to move people and goods more quickly and efficiently across Texas' 28 border crossings. Another major transformation milestone was made in September. In FAR and Texas, well, FAR and TxDOT hosting the groundbreaking ceremony for the $303 million I-2, I-69 interchange, which we all know is desperately needed. This is one of the most significant investments in infrastructure of the Rio Grande Valley. Finally, as I finish my term as founding chair of the RGBMPO in October, I am honored to have accomplished what we set out to do through regionalization of transportation, infrastructure, and the windfall investment of funding for our road projects. It is estimated that the Rio Grande Valley will receive more than $11 billion to address the transportation needs of this region thanks to the RGVMPO. So congratulations, RGVMPO. Now in June, major storms hit our area, caused devastation, flooding, and damage to FAR homes and businesses. Now FAR swiftly responded to remove the water from the streets and neighborhoods, and we continue to work on ongoing drainage infrastructure improvement projects to reduce the impact of future flooding. In November, we hosted a regional municipal drainage committee meeting to discuss drainage issues impacting Hidalgo County. The committee was created to coordinate efforts to mitigate stormwater drainage events and to develop best practices, ordinances, and other measures to further solidify efforts to regionalize solutions to our drainage needs. Said simply, the city's gathered and we want to be sure that all developers, commercial or residential, everybody uses the appropriate drainage, pipes, ditches, what is necessary, no cutting corners or profiteering. There's no city that's going to be allowing for variances to occur, because at the end, you will pay the price, or your neighboring cities or neighbor will pay the price with all that water. Now in FAR, we anticipate the completion of both Hidalgo County drainage bond projects and the citywide drainage projects to be completed by June of this year. Yes, June of this year. Just in time for hurricane season. Everything we do in FAR is strategically planned and executed. For these efforts, I'd like to recognize my colleagues, the FAR City Commission. Could you please stand? And of course, our County Commissioner, who always seems to get things done, Eddie Cantu. Can you please stand and be recognized? Thank you for your drainage efforts. Thank you, Eddie. Other significant city accomplishments for the year, including the opening of FAR's first dog park and regional detention facility to help with drainage issues. It keeps our pets healthy and the owners. So, there you go. We unveiled FAR's time capsule that will be housed in the Development and Research Center for decades, filled with items, tokens, and mementos captured of our lives today, and to be opened by our descendants. We also unveiled the mayor's mural at the newly renovated City Hall, first floor, honoring all the mayors who have led this great city. We created, in partnership with the FAR Economic Development Corporation, the FAR EDC Foundation, and awarded FAR students with first ever FAR EDC Foundation scholarships, providing over 122 students with $2,000 scholarships each. Also, FAR joined forces with a new partner, the Military Highway Water Supply Corporation, through an interlocal agreement to interconnect our systems to expand water for residents and businesses and improve services to the area in a collaborative but mutually prosperous manner. This will lead to major development in South Far. So I'd like to thank my partners. Can you please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Finally, we all have learned during this pandemic how critical basic infrastructure is to our existence. One significant area of infrastructure is broadband. Broadband does not exist equally throughout the nation, and especially in the RGV. It is unfortunate that the city of Far was identified as the least connected community in the nation. The least connected. But don't despair. That is why we have strategically invested and aligned our city plan for long-term success. With or without state or federal funding, we're getting it done. Closing the digital divide is critical because having universal access to high-speed broadband in our digital economy is as essential as having heat, water, or electricity. Connectivity helps Far residents go to school, work remotely, find a job, start a business, access healthcare, and communicate with our loved ones. Now, further investment in this vital public infrastructure will not only strengthen the progress of our city's initial investment, it will boost economic growth and local innovation far into the future. As such, our flagship achievement for 2021 was the launch of Far Citywide Solution to close the digital divide and provide residents with access to high quality, fast, reliable, and most importantly, affordable broadband internet. The speeds are no less than 500 megabytes upload and download available to every resident of Far. And now I give you TeamFar.net.
Good afternoon, Mayor Hernandez, and welcome everyone to State of the City 2022. Yuri Gonzalez reporting from South Far. It's a historic day as we witness the first family getting connected to TeamFar.net, fast, reliable internet. With me, the Santiago family, we actually have Irene Santiago. Big day for you. How are you feeling?
Very excited, very privileged to have fast, reliable internet, finally be able to rely without having any interruptions, any glitches. It's just a necessity that we need to have reliable internet.
How many children do you have?
Five.
And we know that your son, your 10-year-old, Angel Santiago, is here. Sharp kid. He's a student actually with Hidalgo ISD. He's been surfing the net all morning. So we're going into the Santiago home right now. As you know, we witness him logging on to some of the websites that he's been surfing all morning long. So here he is, Angel Santiago, right here surfing through TeamFar.net. How are you feeling today, Angel?
I'm feeling amazing.
What does this mean to you now having fast internet?
It means a lot to me and my family, especially since it's going to be amazing for the entire city of Far.
Now, I see you surfing through multiple websites. Let's see what's happening there.
The other tab is my school district, Hidalgo Park ISD.
Okay.
It's really good. It's a really good school, and I just love it. And I'm sure the fiber optic internet is going to be amazing for everyone, and
you're excited. Excited. You're a little nervous, but I know you're excited.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Angel Santiago, again. And just like Angel, the Santiago family, other residents in Far, school districts, businesses, everyone will have an opportunity to have fast, reliable internet. But that's not all. We have a surprise visitor today with us here with the Santiago family, and that's Hidalgo ISD Superintendent, Mr. Xavier Salinas, that showed up because he also wanted to congratulate the Santiago family. So with us, where is he? Here he is. Mr. Salinas, how are you?
Good, Judy. I'm so happy to be here with the Santiago family. I want to thank Mayor Ambrosio on behalf of our Board of Trustees for the joint partnership we have with the City of Far. The Santiago family, we blessed them with this internet project. So now all her children will have fast, reliable internet service. So, Ms. Santiago, no more excuses for your children not doing your homework. They can get it done on time. So we're just excited about this joint project. We started talking about it 2 years ago, me and Ambrosio, me and Mayor. And now, Mayor, thank you for making this a reality to you and your commission.
Thank you so much again, Mr. Xavier Salinas, Hidalgo ISD superintendent. We also want to thank the Santiago family. Irene, thank you so much for allowing us in your home. And again, it's a great opportunity. Please, everyone, take advantage. Sign up, register. It's teamfar.net, fast, affordable internet. Judy Gonzalez reporting in South Far. Mayor, back to you.
Great. Thank you, Judy. So to recap, TeamFAR.net is available in the city of FAR. It will be completed in a 12-month period. As you were aware of, that was Hidalgo ISD Superintendent Javier Salinas, along with, we recently were notified by Dr. Narciso Garcia of Vanguard. These two school districts, as most school districts, as a matter of fact, all school districts all over the nation, receive generous amount of CARES funding for internet, broadband, or distant learning. If you so choose, as the school district, Hidalgo ISD, and Vanguard Academy are doing, they are paying for their students because it is much more cost-effective to pay for an apartment or a home or a mobile home or a house than to pay for an individual student. It's $25 versus $50 or $60 they're being paying right now from the CARES money. So for our residents, if you so desire to have this high-speed internet, please reach out to your superintendent and your boards, and I'm sure they'll be happy to hear from you. Another thing that we need to mention about this, in FAR, we've always been told, even when I was growing up, you know, there's no way you're going to be a doctor as an orphan. It's not going to happen. There's no way you're going to be a mayor. That's not going to happen. You're not going to be able to do the interchange. You're not going to be able to do a nursing school. You're not going to be able to give money back to your residents. It is impossible, and for sure, you're not going to be able to provide broadband to your residents. Well, absolutely false. And FAR, we get it done, and I'm so proud of our staff and our city manager, assistant city managers, and our city commission for sticking to their vision. And we're very proud of you, and so should the FAR residents be as well. Now, as it's become tradition, every year we honor an individual that embodies the spirit of service, leadership, and pride that his namesake, Mayor Polo Palacios, did throughout his life. So please, please help me welcome to the stage Mayor Polo Palacios. Mayor, welcome, sir. This year, for the first time ever, we are honored to recognize two champions of our legislative efforts who helped take our priorities across the finish line like two champions. On behalf of FAR, we want to thank you for being instrumental in stewarding our transportation and infrastructure bills in the recent 87th legislature in their respective committees on transportation, both on the House and the Senate. This year's recipients of the Leo Polo Palacios Service Award are State Senator Juan Chivinajosa and State Representative Terry Canales. Can you please join us?
Juan Chuy Hinojosa was first elected into office in 1981, serving in the Texas House until 1990, and again from 1997 to 2002, when he was elected into office as Texas State Senator, District 20. As Senator and Vice Chair of the Senate Finance Committee, Hinojosa has consistently put South Texas at the forefront of critical discussions and secured millions of dollars in funding that stimulates our local economies and protects our most vulnerable populations. He truly is a fighter for a better South Texas. Texas State Representative Terry Canales was elected to the House of Representatives in 2012 to represent District 40. In his time in the legislature, Chairman Canales has focused on transparency and open government. Canales has a long history of fighting for our public schools, our current and retired teachers, and ensuring that our students are given an equal opportunity to succeed. In 2021, Canales was reappointed to serve a second session as chairman of the powerful House Transportation Committee. Canales has been instrumental in moving forward critical legislation that benefits FAR, South Texas, and the entire state, and is a true champion for a better South Texas.
two giants in our state capital. Two giants. Thank you. Thank you. But thank you very much. Senator Chuinosa, Chairman Canales, thank you. But don't go anywhere. Wait a minute. Don't go. Hold on a second. We have another surprise for our recipients. We have our two commissioners here. Our other commissioners coming through. They're coming up. Bobby and Itza, Bajardo, Mr. Medina. Can you make your presence known? Don't push Bobby into the pool. Don't do it. As you know, every year, we are grateful to generous sponsors who have made today's event possible. And as we've done every year, we donate excess funds from this event that is 100% funded by sponsor donations. We select a nonprofit or a community organization that are working to improve conditions and the quality of life of families in FAR and the surrounding communities. And we're doing things a little different this year. The first grant award will actually be split between the two recipients. We have decided to allow the Polo Palacios Award recipients, Senator Chuinosa and Representative Terry Canales, to each award a $2,500 grant to the organization of their choice. We're proud to be able to do this in your honor, quite frankly. And note that whatever organization you pick, I am sure will be worthy of this award. So congratulations, gentlemen. Thank you. They can step down. Not him. Our rep. Thank you, sir. Hold on a second. Now, for our second award. In alignment with this year's theme, we are proud to present a grant in the amount of $5,000 to UTRGV Aquatics, headed by UTRGV Vice President and Director of Athletics, Chase. Is Chase here today? Thought I had seen him. Can he come up to the stage, please?
With students voting overwhelmingly to support the expansion of athletic programs to enhance the UTRGV experience for our campus community and for the entire Rio Grande Valley, the university will now be expanding its intercollegiate competitive sports programs to include football and swimming and diving programs. The new UTRGV Aquatics program is expected to be operational in the next couple of years.
Thank you, Chase. I'm sure you'll make good use of that money. Thank you, sir. Thank you for coming out here, and thank you for what you do for UTRGV in our community. Congratulations, sir. You can take that with you. I don't think they'll catch it, but you can take it with you. You can go to the bank now. Yeah. Right this way. Thank you, sir. The third and final grant recipient of the amount of $5,000 is to PSJ's ISD's aquatic program, led by Aquatic Director Jonathan Landeros. Please join us on the stage.
The PSJ ISD aquatics team consists of varsity swimming, diving, and club water polo, and boasts an impressive 11 district championships in just 8 years of existence. The team has produced 5 regional championships and 9 all-state athletes in swimming and diving. The aquatics team starts in middle school with 6th grade intro to aquatics, 7th and 8th grade year-round aquatics, competing in UIL swimming, diving, and upcoming new UIL sport, water polo.
Yes, with us today from PSJ Aquatics Program, of course, we have our superintendent, Dr. Redondo. We also have some school board members with us, of course, Dr. Cynthia Gutierrez, Mr. Jesse Vela, Jorge Palacios, and Dr. Trevino, my apologies. Thank you, gentlemen, for being here today. And Jonathan, you ready to get your check?
Yes, sir.
Don't spend it all in one place, sir. So let's get our check up here. There it is.
Don't try taking that one to the bank. Wait for the good one.
Thank you, PSJ, and congratulations to your aquatic team.
Thank you, sir. Absolutely. Doc? No, congratulations to you guys. Yes, absolutely.
Dr. Redondo, that's not for Speedos. No Speedos. Don't do it. As last year and every year from now on, we will always aim to recognize the city department that goes above and beyond our normal responsibilities. With our monumental broadband project, TeamFAR.net, and the various other communications and technology projects that this department manages to keep our city operational. So this year's TeamFAR award goes out to FAR's Innovative and Technology Department, headed by Director Jose Peñas. Congratulations, Jose. There you are. Come on over here. Jose, who calls you more, me or your wife? I don't think he wants to tell anybody. Sorry about all the calls, but I wanted broadband done, and thank you for getting it done. Congratulations to your department once again, sir. All right? We're good. Thank you, gentlemen. Ladies, thank you, Commissioner, for joining us. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of my colleagues on the FAR City Commission and all our employees, thank you all for joining us today. And remember, in 2022, the city of FAR is prospering, highly innovated, exceeding expectations, and continuing to strive towards excellence. We look forward to the year ahead because together, as I stated, we will win. God bless and have a wonderful day.